All right, good morning. It's past time. I was oohing and aahing over the new baby. Oh, so precious. Yeah, I'm talking about you. That little boy is precious. Ah, okay. Thank you, Jesus, for the opportunity to be here today. Lord, we just love to come and worship you and be in your presence. Lord, I love to come and worship you. I love to worship you. And I pray your power, your glory will fill the sanctuary this morning as we just stand before you in awe and give you all of our praise. Thank you, Jesus. In your precious name we pray, Lord. Amen. Let's do it.
Jesus Christ, I worship and adore you. Every day I live, I'm living for you. What else can I say? You've overtaken me. Every day with you is getting better. Every word from you is like a treasure. Giving all of me and finding more of you. Worship you, my King. Jesus Christ, I thank you for the love you've given me. Though I deserve nothing, everything I have, I owe it all to you. Nothing that this world has got to offer satisfies my soul. I still hunger, pouring out my heart and filling up with you.
God, you're taking over all of me. I'm letting go so you can come and have your way in me. Behind, 'cause Jesus has saved my life. Now every day I worship you, my King.
Jesus Christ, I worship and adore you. Every day I live, I'm living for you. What else can I say? You've overtaken me.
God, you're taking over all of me. I'm letting go so you can come and have your way in me. I'm leaving all behind, 'cause Jesus, you saved my life. Now every day I worship you, my King.
God, you're taking, God, you're taking over all of me. I'm letting go so you can come have your way in me. I leave it all behind, 'cause Jesus, you saved my life. Now every day I worship you, my King. Oh, I worship you, Lord, I worship you. Hallelujah, Lord, we praise you. Glory to his name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We praise you. Lord, we praise you. Glory to your name. Praise awaits you, Lord, in this place today.
Praise awaits you in this place today, oh Lord. We are gathered ready, God, to sing your praise. Ready to respond to the glories of your name, to the wonders of your heart, to your great love.
praise. Ready to respond to the glories of your name, to the wonders of your heart, to your great love. Praise is waiting for you in this place.
There's a cry that our spirits will make
as we see your glory.
To your mercies our souls will awake, and we'll sing till the break of the day,
because you are worthy. Yes, Lord. To your great love, we're ready to respond.
We're ready to respond
to the glories of your name,
to the glories of your name,
to the wonders of your heart,
to the wonders of your heart,
to your great love. As we see your glory.
To your mercies our souls will awake, and we'll sing till the break of the day,
because you are worthy. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord, we praise your name. Lord, we give our praise to you. We sing our hallelujahs to you, Lord. Glory to your name. Lord, we praise you and we glorify your name, Lord Jesus. And Holy Spirit, we ask you to come today. Lord, awaken our hearts this morning. Awaken our hearts, Lord. Bring unity to this place. Lord, we just worship you and we want to follow you. Lord, we want to stand up on your word, Lord, and proclaim the glory of Jesus Christ in this place today. And Lord, as we go forth this week, Lord, we want your glory to shine through us, Father, as we worship you. Let the power of the Holy Spirit flood us today. Fill us up, Lord, overflowing as we worship you. And we thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Lord, you are mighty. Glory. You said if we would pray and we would see, and humbly lay our lives down at your feet, that you would bring us to a place
where earth and heaven meet for your glory.
We have come to kneel before your throne with faith and confidence in you alone. You would heal our land
and overwhelm us with your hope for your glory. Make us holy. Come like the sound of roaring thunder. Cover the earth with signs and wonders. Bring an awakening. Bring an awakening. Come and consume us with your power. Jesus, we need you in this hour. Bring an awakening. Bring an awakening. We need an awakening.
Increase of your kingdom has no end. So we, our church, will rise and take a stand. Miracles and life will flow
as we reach out our hands for your glory. Make us whole. cover the earth with signs and wonders. Bring an awakening. Bring an awakening. Come and consume us with your power. Jesus, we need you in this hour. Bring an awakening. Bring an awakening. We call out to the broken. We cry out for the hopeless, commanding those in darkness, come away, come away. We liberate the captives. We activate the passive. We scream out to the masses, come away, come away. We call out to the broken. We cry out for the hopeless, commanding those in darkness, come away, come away. We liberate the captives. We activate the passive. We scream out to the masses, come away, come away. Come like the sound of roaring thunder. Cover the earth with signs and wonders. Bring an awakening. Bring an awakening. Come and consume us with your power. Jesus, we need you in this hour. Bring an awakening. Bring an awakening. Come like the sound of roaring thunder. Cover the earth with signs and wonders. Bring an awakening. Bring an awakening. Come and consume us with your power. Jesus, we need you in this hour. Bring an awakening. Bring an awakening. Bring an awakening. Bring an awakening, we need an awakening. Yes, Lord, we do. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Lord, we seek your face this morning. Lord, we seek your power this morning. Lord, awaken our hearts to you, Jesus. Lord, help us to hear your voice, Lord, as you instruct us, Lord, the paths we need to take, Lord Jesus, as you comfort us in times of hurt, Lord Jesus. Lord, as you heal our bodies in times of need, Lord, we need you. And Lord, we need to awaken to your voice, to your spirit. We press into you this morning, Lord. Lord, we press into you today. Hallelujah.
You come this morning in reverence to me and to my name. You come in humility before me, says the Lord. You come awaiting for action on my part, and I will show up, and I will show off, and I will do things that you cannot imagine in your own life, in your own town, and in the world stage. Watch me, says the Lord. Watch me. I am about to show off to the world, says the Lord.
Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Father, we are watching you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to your name. Thank
you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We have so much to be thankful for, Lord Jesus. And Lord, though times may change, may get harder, Father, we are trusting in you, Lord, and we are watching you, Lord. We see the signs, Father, of your coming, Lord. We see what's going on, Lord Jesus, and it just causes us to look up. And Father, we are looking at you. We are watching and waiting for you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Mighty is your name.
All my words fall short. I got nothing new. How could I express all my gratitude? I could sing these songs as I often do. But every song must end, and you never do. So I throw up my hands and praise you again and again. 'Cause all that I have is a hallelujah, hallelujah. And I know it's not much, but I've nothing else fit for a king except for a heart singing hallelujah, hallelujah. I've got one response, I've got just one move, with my arms stretched wide, I will worship you. So I throw up my hands and praise you again and again. 'Cause all that I have is a hallelujah, hallelujah. And I know it's not much, but I've nothing else fit for a except for a heart singing hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, my soul, oh, don't you get shy on me. Lift up your song, 'cause you've got a lion inside of those lungs. Get up and praise the Lord. Come on, my soul, oh, don't you get shy on me. Lift up your song, 'cause you've got a lion inside of those lungs. Get up and praise the Lord. Come on, my soul, oh, don't you get shy on me. Lift up your song, 'cause you've got a lion inside of those lungs. Get up and praise the Lord. All that I have is a hallelujah, hallelujah. And I know it's not much, but I've nothing else fit for a king except for a heart singing hallelujah, hallelujah. all that I have is a hallelujah, hallelujah. And I know it's not much, but I'm nothing else fit for a king except for a heart singing hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, we praise you, Lord. Just sing, keep singing your praises to him. Lord, we praise you. We praise you anyway. You are my God, my Savior, Lord. We praise you again and again with our hallelujahs. Hallelujah. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus, we praise you. I am so thankful, Lord. Mighty is your name. Oh, Rabashalabo Koramasara Yeshundo Taramasi. Hilamotora Masharai. Hilamotora Shanarabakarai. And Yashi. Oh, I praise you.
Look up.
Yes.
And pray. Continue to praise. Reach
yes.
up.
Yes.
For I am about to open the gates of heaven and pour out all that your idea, all that you desire, but not everything that you want. And I, Lord, say again, I am here. I am with you. Look up, and I will receive you. I will receive you, my children, for I do not deny my children. I do not turn you back, but I, the Lord, say, come.
Yes.
Come, seek my face and seek me, for I am about to throw open the doors of heaven.
Yes.
Thank you. Oh, thank you for your words of encouragement. Jesus, Lord, we do look up. Lord, I am so excited for the days to come. So excited, Lord Jesus, because I know it just draws me closer to you, closer to standing and facing you, Lord, face to face. Hallelujah, what a day that will be. Hallelujah. Oh, what a day that will be. Hallelujah, Jesus, we praise you. What a day, hallelujah. Oh, Jesus, hallelujah, glory to your name. Glory to your name. We praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. We praise you anywhere. We praise you anywhere. I know that this song, that those thoughts have gone through my mind all this week. Lord, I'll be in my car and I'll come back. That thought will come to me. I will praise you anywhere. Hallelujah. And Lord, I do that today. I praise you. I praise you. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to his name. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, what a day. Hallelujah. Praise his name. Thank you, Jesus.
Sometimes you gotta dance through the darkness, sing through the fire, praise when it don't make sense. Sometimes you gotta stare down the giant, worship from the lion's den.
Sometimes you gotta shout it from the mountain, louder in the valley, trusting that he's gonna get you there. Sometimes you gotta welcome the wonder, wait for the answer, worship with your hands in the air. I'll praise you anywhere. Praise, give me praise, give me praise in the highest. Praise, give me praise, give me praise in the highest. He is worthy, yes, he is worthy of all of the praise. Sometimes you gotta praise in the prison, cry out to heaven, shout until the doors swing wide. Sometimes you gotta stand on your shackles, brave in the battle, worship with your hands held high. I'll praise you anywhere. Praise, give me praise, give me praise in the highest. Praise, give me praise, give me praise in the highest. He is worthy, yes, he is worthy of all of the praise. Give me praise, give me praise in the highest. Praise, give me praise, give me praise in the highest. He is worthy, yes, he is worthy of all of the praise. Faithful all my life, blessing day and night, countless reasons why. I'll praise you anywhere. Every promise kept, goodness every step, each and every breath, I'll praise you anywhere. Faithful all my life, blessing day and night, countless reasons why. I'll praise you anywhere. Every promise kept, goodness every step, each and every breath, I'll praise you anywhere. Praise, give me praise, give me praise in the highest. Praise, give me praise, give me praise in the highest. He is worthy, yes, he is worthy of all of the praise. Oh, I will give him praise. Oh, mountain, oh, valley, I know that you're with me there. I'll praise you anywhere. Oh, give him praise this morning. Shout out to him. Father, we praise you. We thank you. We glorify your name. Hallelujah, Lord.
God is good. Hallelujah. I will praise you where?
Anywhere.
Are we anywhere? How many are anywhere right now? Let's give him another praise offering this morning. Hallelujah, Lord. We just praise you. We glorify your name, for you're the King of kings and the Lord of lords, and we give you glory and honor and praise. And today, Lord, in GracePointe Church, no stone is going to cry out for us, because we're joining with the angels of heaven, and we're crying, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. You're our soon coming King. You're the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the Prince of Peace, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father. You're our healer. You're our deliverer, our salvation. You are our all in all. And Lord, we lift our hands and we lift our voices and we cry, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, worthy to receive all glory, worthy to receive all worship. And Lord God, receive our praise, receive our worship. Holy, 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 holy. Glory to your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm going to have a Pentecostal fit up here. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. Hallelujah. Thank you, worship team. God is good. Hallelujah. The last service before Thanksgiving. Can you believe it? Next week is Thanksgiving. You know, they always told me as you get older, time goes even faster. And you know what? I always thought that was stupid, but they're right. It goes faster and faster. But praise God, that means I'm one day closer to seeing my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Yeah. I'm one day, either the rapture of the church happens or I meet him through the grave, I'm one day closer to see my Maker. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And you know what? It's going to be a glorious thing to be around that throne and to praise him. Hallelujah. God is so, so, so good. I want to welcome everyone to GracePointe Church today, where your past does not define your future. I am so grateful for his grace and his mercy and his love that he gives to each and every one of us. I'm also so grateful for the gifts of the Spirit in operation. Amen. Now, you may be kind of wondering what was going on there. There was someone who spoke forth in a language that you did not know, and it may have startled you, and those who are listening online, that may you may not have seen that before. And then there was kind of a pause, then someone gave a message in English. I want to tell you that is the gifts of the Holy Spirit in operation. That is called in tongues and interpretation of tongues, and there was a prophecy after that. But 1 Corinthians 12 says this, "Now concerning spiritual gifts, brethren, I would not have you be ignorant." And then down to verse 10, to another working in miracles, another prophecy, to another discerning of spirits, and there are diverse kinds of tongues, and to another interpretation of tongues. And what we experienced in that first move there was simply this. God spoke to someone to speak in a language they did not know. Then God spoke to someone else to interpret the language they did not know, to prove to us that God is on the throne and God is in control. And whenever those messages come across, they should be edifying and building up. And I don't know about you, I wanted to shout, because my God is getting ready to do something great. Amen? He's getting ready to do something great. And we're going to praise him anywhere. Everywhere. Amen? Hallelujah. So we're going to continue in this series, Praise You Anywhere. This is the second message in the series. And this one's simply titled, Thanksgiving Equals Praise Demonstrated. Thanksgiving equals praise equals praise demonstrated. As a nation here, we're getting ready to gather around and have family and friends over, and we're going to celebrate eating good food. How many are going to have some good food? We're going to celebrate eating some good food, and hopefully we're going to have some great fellowship minus the politics and the wokeness. Everyone agreed? Amen. And I want to add another one of those. Let's get rid of cell phones. At least for one meal, put the cell phones away. I remember a time where my kids all got together and we were just, I think it was Thanksgiving, and I'm looking around and I'm in the kitchen working and all that, and I'm looking around, they're all on their phones. Like, why bother to be here? Their Thanksgiving is in their phone. You know, it wouldn't hurt us in America for at least a couple hours to put the phone down and look at each other face to face and say, how are you doing? Tell me about what's going on in your life. Amen? Yeah, and of course we call this time, we're going to be celebrating here Thanksgiving. And simply, Thanksgiving is one of the ways that we show praise to our God. And we show praise to our God in many, many, many different ways. And the scripture will show us many, and there's other ways we can do it. But we as a nation need to thank God and praise God for his bounty that he's given to us. I don't know about you, but I am glad that God has blessed America. I am so glad that God has blessed me. Anyone else glad you're blessed today? And I look around the economy out there, and I see the high things that are going out of control, but my God still supplies all my needs according to his riches and glory through Christ Jesus our Lord. So I have a reason to be thankful this Thanksgiving. My God has once again proven himself faithful. He has met my needs, and we want to thank God and praise God for his bounty and his blessings, all his provision, all his love, and all his care this Thanksgiving. But most of all, I want to thank God for, number one, being my God. He's just not a God among gods. He is the Almighty God. And I need to praise him simply because he is God. And then secondary, I can praise him for this. He redeemed me. My sins have been removed from me as far as the east is from the west. Hallelujah. My name is now written down in the Lamb's Book of Life. And when my God the Father sees me, he sees the blood of his Son, Jesus Christ, and he sees me as the righteousness of God in Christ right this very moment. My past does not define my future, because Jesus is my future. Amen. So we can praise him. He has taken away my punishment that I earned for my rebellion. Now, I know none of you have ever rebelled, right? But God's taken away our punishment when we receive his Son as our Lord and Savior. We have a reason to be thankful today and every day. Amen? Hallelujah. So this Thanksgiving, we're going to declare the praises of our God, for he is worthy to receive all glory and honor and praise. Amen? Hallelujah. That leads me to the first point here this morning. I think it's important. Point number one, if you're taking notes. When a nation neglects giving thanksgiving and praise to God, that nation will go into decline. I'm not talking about decline here. I'm talking about a spiritual decline and a moral decline. And our forefathers, when they came to America, they came looking for God. They came looking for a place where they were free to worship God apart from the government regulations and restrictions. And I want to tell you, it doesn't take long to look in America that they're going to try to put restrictions on people's free will, the free will to worship as they choose and please to worship. You can see it coming. And the reason I believe that some of that's coming into our nation right now is because as a nation, we are failing, I think big time, of praising God for who He is and praising God for the bounty He has given to us. And because of that praise isn't on our lips, our minds become a little slower and slower and slower when things, the spiritual things, and Satan is stealing from America what God has blessed us with. And I think it's time to declare, Satan, you have no right or authority to take America's blessings. And what we as God's people need to start doing is praising our God on a regular basis, because it does something to our minds. As a man, remember, thinketh, so is what? He. And if I am praising God in my mind, and I'm praising God with my voice continually, it begins to affect the way I think, the way I see things, and the way I act. And I think it's time for the church in America, and I say most of the churches in America, to rise up once again and begin to put praise back into their church services. Amen? You see, our forefathers, when they came here, were looking for God. They weren't looking for gold. And because they came here looking for God, God provided everything else that they needed. And here is the key. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and what? God will add all these other things. But if I'm seeking first the kingdoms of this world, I will begin to lose those other things. God is good, isn't He? And I am convinced that the United States of America is one of the most blessed nations in the world, because we started with the foundation, God is the ruler of our land and our nation. And may we get back to that truth once again, that if it wasn't for God, we would have nothing whatsoever. But with God, praising Him, following Him, He will meet all our needs according to His riches and glory through Christ Jesus, our Lord. Do we have a reason to be thankful this Thanksgiving? Amen. You see, saints of God, when we fail to praise Him, we begin to forget about His benefits and His blessings that He's given to us. And what is a very dangerous thing is this, is that we begin then to depend upon our own strength and our own power and our own might for the things that we have, and then we give credit to ourselves. Look what I did in my own strength and my own might. Let me tell you right now, if that's your attitude, you need to start praising God. Amen. Because you're praising yourself. Yeah. And God will not share His glory with anyone else, including me and you. Amen? You see, when a nation begins to decline, God will start withdrawing His benefits from that nation. And if you look around at the moral decay in our land right now, God is withdrawing His blessings. But thank God for the small remnant. And guess what? I don't know about you, but I'm a part of the remnant. I'm a part of that small remnant of God. And we are not going to give up without a fight. And we are going to praise our God. We're going to appreciate our God for His kindness. We're not going to forget His benefits. You know, we talk about the first Thanksgiving, about the pilgrims and the Native Americans and how they came together and have this big feast. They don't even teach that anymore. And if they do teach it, they teach it some kind of weird way that makes it look like a terrible, terrible, terrible thing happened. But I want to tell you today, the pilgrims' Thanksgiving was not the first Thanksgiving. God instituted Thanksgiving in the Old Testament many, many, many years ago. And there was a celebration of Thanksgiving in the Old Testament about when God provided and met people's needs. So what we're doing, we have Thanksgiving. We're fulfilling what the Bible commands us to do, to praise Him everywhere. Amen? Hallelujah. You see, true thanksgiving, true worship should be a celebration and a part of our spiritual worship on a regular basis. And I want to understand, I want us to understand this on our spiritual worship. Don't limit it to the house of God. Our spiritual worship, our spiritual praise needs to go outside the four walls. There's a world out there that is hungry and seeking for truth, and they're seeking for truth in all the wrong places, and all the cults have showed up, and all the demonic things have shown up, and they're showing them, quote, power. I want to tell you, saints of God, this world needs to see real power. And His name is Jesus Christ. Amen? He is the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but by Him. And saints of God, we need to show forth the praises of Him who's called us out of darkness into His marvelous light. Hallelujah. Not just in the church, but out there. Amen? Hallelujah. We must make sure, I believe, this time of celebration, this national holiday that we call Thanksgiving, and by the way, a holiday means this holy day. Amen? So when they were saying happy holidays, they thought they were getting rid of Christ. They just messed up. Because holiday simply meant holy day. What's the most holiest day in the world as far as I'm concerned? The birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. They still got it wrong. Amen? And those who were trying to get rid of Christ by putting a big X mess, and people threw a fit, Christians threw a fit, they're trying to take Christ out. You know what? How you write Christ's name in the Greek? One big X. So they got it wrong again. You can't take it away. It's all about Jesus. Amen? Hallelujah. And so, saints of God, we cannot neglect praising our God everywhere we go. And here's what I'm convinced of. I believe if we will trade depression, discouragement, and despair for praise, we would find a lot of people healed and delivered from emotional issues in their lives. Because as a man thinketh, so is he. And when I begin to praise God, I want to tell you, discouragement can't stay. When I'm praising God and the fruit of my lips is being offered up as a sacrifice, depression does not have a right. And we have to learn to praise God everywhere we are, no matter what the circumstances are, no matter what we're facing. We're going to stand on those shackles. We're going to praise till this prison door swing wide. I love that new song. Oh, hallelujah. I've been singing that. I've been waking up with that song on my mind. You know what? Because there is so much truth in that song that will bring victory to a child of God's life, saints of God, because it's found in Scripture. It is the Word of God. I believe that song is anointed of God in a great and mighty way to set us free. Hallelujah. And I need to practice that. Anyone else need to practice that? I need to practice that. Because, saints of God, here it just simply is this. We are living in the time before our Lord and Savior's return, and we cannot be sitting by idly and just doing nothing. Amen? Now, the next truth today is this. When a church neglects giving thanksgiving and praise to God, the church will go into decline. Now, one of the ways I can praise God is through my sign language. I love sign language. And it's so awesome. You know, not everyone knows sign language, but I can stay up here and praise God to these songs and everything. That's one of my ways of offering God praise. Amen? And it may offend people, but I don't care. You may not like it, but I don't care because it's not about you. It's between me and God. I'm praising Him. And there's things in each and every one of our lives that we do that God has given us a skill about that we can use to praise our God. Amen? Well, and the church ought to be really free about worshiping Him. Amen? The praising, that ought to be free. We ought to be free, free, free. And I want to say this, when you know, this is a sign like this. Can you do this? That means exciting and enthusiastic. And you know what that sign also means? You ready for this? Methodist. Everyone's going, You know why it was Methodist? Because at one time, the Methodist Church was known as the Shouting Methodist. They were full of the power of God. They were full of the Holy Spirit. People were being saved. They were exciting people to be around. They were Methodists. And that's the deaf gave that sign to that church because they were exciting. What happened? They went from being exciting to dead. What happened? They stopped praising their God. And here is a danger. How many want to be accepted? How many like to be accepted? I like to be accepted. I don't like to be rejected. I like to be accepted. Everyone likes to be accepted. Well, when a church goes into decline, they become less and less spiritual. They become less and less biblical. And they begin to turn away. And sometimes us Pentecostals want to be accepted by those who are turning away. And so we put limits on how we can praise God because we don't want to offend anyone. And I'm saying the gospel offends those who are not right with Jesus. Amen? And if you sports fans can throw up your hands, throw your popcorn and your liquid gold stuff that you spot when your team gets a touchdown, why can't I throw my hands in the air and praise the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords and give Him praise? Why are we afraid to offend those who are walking away? And I want to tell you, saints of God, I believe this to be true. God will send people who are looking for a church that is full of the power and the anointing of God. And God wants us to be who He's called us to be, a group of praisers that aren't afraid to praise Him the way He has instructed us to praise Him. Amen? You see, saints of God, I am convinced the more that we are people of praise, the closer we will be to the Word of God, the more we will do the will of God, because praise keeps our minds focused where it needs to be, on God. No matter my circumstances, no matter my trial, no matter my difficulty, no matter my health issue, I am going to praise God everywhere I go. When I'm in that line at Walmart, and the only thing's open is the self-service lines there, and they got carts backed up with keeping things like this, will take you an hour, I'm still going to learn to praise Him anywhere. Because maybe I'm being held back because God knows it's going to be an accident, and He's keeping me from the accident. So many things I believe one of these days we're going to see in heaven, how God has spared us, how God has protected us. We have no idea about it, but that's why we need to keep that attitude of praise. My God is in control. He's ruling and reigning, and I'm going to praise Him everywhere I go. Hallelujah. And I am more convinced than ever that God has a tailor-made revival for GracePointe Church. Not a revival like every other revival, but one for this church right here. And I believe one revival starting here that can flow out from this church into our community, into our county, into our state, into our nation, and around the world. We need a fresh pouring out spirit of the Holy Spirit like we had in the day of Pentecost, and we need a fresh one like we had the day of Topeka, Kansas. God can send a mighty revival to America again, and I believe that's going to happen through a group of people who are going to praise Him no matter what. You see, I believe we get caught up too much in our feelings. I like good feelings. Anyone like good feelings? Hallelujah for good feelings. I don't like bad feelings. But when we allow our feelings to dictate our response to God, we are going to get ourselves in trouble every time. Our feelings may be down. That means I need to press in even more with praise and worship. I need to press in with everything within me. You know, I remember a time when I was first saved, and I had three vehicles. I was 17 or 18 at that time. I had a brand new Chevy Nova, Rally Nova. I had a 68 Camaro, and I had a 64 Dodge pickup truck. I was single, living by myself. What did I need all that for? I just wanted it. And I remember coming home from work, parking out front of my house where my Camaro was and my Rally Nova was brand new. My first car I bought brand new. It was awesome. And I walk into the back there where my garage was, and a neighbor could have taken a cement block and thrown it through my windshield of my pickup truck. Well, needless to say, I'm not able to drive that one, right? Can't drive that thing with the windshield out and a cement block in the front seat. Well, I wasn't very happy, but okay. And then about 2 o'clock in the morning, I hear a big smash and crash in the front yard. I hear a second crash in the front yard. And I get up and look, and there are my two cars in the front yard, off the street, both totaled out. So I had three vehicles. My cars are totaled out. And now I don't have any car to go anywhere in. So I get on the phone. It's like, you know, can you help me? You know, can I, you know, it's Sunday morning. Okay, it happened Saturday. Well, it was early Sunday morning. I was going to go to church. I was determined I was going to go to church. I don't care if I had to walk. I started to call some people, and I got a ride to church. And you know, when I got to church, you know what I did? I raised my hands in the air on that praise and worship service, and I praised my God. And one of the reasons I could praise my God for was this: no one got hurt in it. Amen? The lady who hit me was drunk, and she took off, and guess what? The police found her. They just followed the trail, okay, to her place. You know, she didn't get away with that, okay? But no matter what was going on, I lifted my hands. I was praising God. I wasn't thinking about anyone around me. But some of the people knew what just happened at my home. Lost all three of my vehicles in one shot, or one earlier and two later. And there were people there that I wasn't aware of, knew what was going on, but they knew about it. And they said they decided they would give their life to Jesus because they saw how I was praising God with what just happened. And they were convinced in their mind that God must be real. And they got saved over that. Does that seem weird? I wasn't the one who saved them. But them watching me praise God with a sincere heart, even in the midst of the storm, convinced them that God was real. Saints, now let's get honest here. How do we respond when life isn't going the way we want it to go? Woe is me. Yeah, I'm not denying those things aren't real. But as a man thinketh, so is he. And at that point in time is when you need to stand on those shackles and praise your God. There's a time that you, in that valley, you shout even louder and louder and louder. In other words, you take authority over the thoughts in your life. And you know what I've learned? When you take authority over the thoughts of your life begins to line up with your new thoughts. If I don't take authority over the thoughts in my life will line up with the wrong thoughts. Amen? Hallelujah. We praise God because He is God. Amen? Now, there was a time in the Pentecostal churches that you knew you were in a Pentecostal church. I remember going to my first Pentecostal church and thinking, these people are whacked. They are nuts. May we return to the time when people think we're whacked. Amen? And I believe that God is calling us into a deeper, deeper, deeper relationship with Him through our praise. Now, let me say this right now. I prayed and asked God what He thought about our worship service, our praise service, our church. You think that's something I ought to do once in a while? I think I need to take inventory once in a while. Not only am I myself personally, but as being one of the leaders here at the church, I need to take inventory. And what God spoke to me clearly was this, is that he was very pleased with the praise and worship here at GracePointe Church. He was very pleased with the word that's going forth. That made me happy. Amen? And God shared this with me. That is why you are sensing my spirit and my power in a mighty way. Because what you are doing is honoring me, and it's a sweet-smelling savor that comes up before my throne room. I don't know about you, that made me happy. Amen? And here's what else God revealed to me. We realize this church is not mine. It's God's. Let me give you a fact that I hope doesn't happen for a long time. If I were to leave this world today, this church would go on. You know why? It's not built on a man, human man like me. It's built upon the man, Christ Jesus, who is God manifested in the flesh. Everyone better say,
amen.
Amen. And God also was revealing to me, which we already know, that we allow the Spirit of God to flow in our church. Amen? A lot of churches don't do that today. You can't allow the Holy Spirit to flow and move because you might be getting something really messed up, you know, or whatever's going on here. It might offend someone, but you know what? The Holy Spirit is in control when he's here, and I want to be a servant of God who will yield to his leading when it comes to things that happen in the service. Now, do I get it 100% right? Probably not. But pray that I hear more and more that I do get it right. Amen? And then he said right now, because we're pleasing to him, there is an anointing in this service. There's an anointing on God's people here. There is the manifest presence of God here. Saints of God, we ought to get happy here. The operations of the Holy Spirit are operating here. And God spoke to me that he is going to send the revival that we've been asking for and seeking for. Hallelujah. And did he spoke to us through the gifts of the Spirit today? Something great's going to happen. I believe it's going to be that revival. Hallelujah. Yeah. And over our church door, the glory of God resides here. You see, when a church goes in decline and starts falling away from God, his ways, his principles, his way of worshiping him, eventually, God will put Ichabod over the door, which means the glory of God has departed. See, saints of God, next point is this. We as God's children are created to praise God, and praise brings change. How many want to see change? How many want to see change in your life? How many want to see change in the church? Good change. How many want to see good change in your home? Well, one of the weapons is praise. Fill your home with praise. Fill your workplace with praise. I remember when I was working in a gas station garage, as many, many, many years ago. That's when you had to pump, you know, you had to go out and pump people's gas. They couldn't pump their own gas. Anybody remember those days? Well, one of my coworkers was just simply, I loved the guy to death, but he was an unbeliever, what horrible unbeliever. And I mean, they had the pictures on the wall that you see that gas stations have and all that kind of stuff. And I'm saved, and I just don't want to see that stuff. I don't want to hear the music that they're playing. So I asked the Holy Spirit, how do I change this? How do I make a difference here? And I came up with a plan. The Holy Spirit said, since we were working here together, half the day you get to choose your music, and the other half of the day I get to choose my music. So half of the day we were listening to his. I won't type what kind of music it was. It was terrible, horrible music. And the rest of the day, I put on a Christian radio station. I filled that garage full of praise. Hallelujah. Yeah. And you know what happened? He came to me. He said, let's just do it this way. I won't play my music and you don't play yours. I was happy with that. Yeah. Because I wasn't filling my mind with that other stuff. And then before long, he took the posters down off the walls. Because Mia turned the radio off, but I didn't turn this off. And all of a sudden, I would yell out, "Praise the Lord!" Or when the time I got my hand caught in the tire-changing machine, and it hit me, and Father broke my hand, and I said, "Praise God!" And he kept, "Why are you praising God?" Well, I said, "Well, because you guys praise the devil with your language all the time. All those foul words that are coming out of your mouth constantly, you're constantly giving the devil praise." Well, hallelujah, I'm here to give God praise. And you know what change came? They cleaned up their mouths. I want to tell you, praise is a powerful weapon that will change situations. Amen? You see, praise blesses God. Amen? Praise blesses us. And praise brings God's blessings into our situation. Praise changes things because the devil cannot stand praise. Everyone agreed, said? Next point is this. God made everything that he made to praise him for all eternity. What are you going to do when you get to heaven? How long is heaven?
Forever.
All of creation was created to praise God. The scripture talks about the fields, the trees of the field shall clap their hands. Yeah. It says the stones will cry out if we don't cry out. You know, and it says all of the heavens declare the glory of God. How much of the heavens do? All of it. All of creation was created to praise God. The four living creatures and the book of Revelation are around the throne. And these four living creatures represent all of creation. And these four living creatures are constantly praising God before his throne. Constantly praising him. The angelic beings found in Isaiah chapter 6. You know, and they are before the throne of God there. And they're constantly crying, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty." They're constantly praising him. And they're praising God to his face. You see, we will spend all eternity offering praise to God. So here's what I want to say here. We need to start practicing our praise now. I praise God for our worship team. Amen? But I'm praising God that they practice before we come up and have a service. Amen? Worship team? Aren't you glad of that? They're practicing before we have a service. Yes, I believe in the anointing. Oh, yes, I believe it powerfully. And I believe that God anoints the practice. Yeah. So they can play skillfully unto the Lord and to us. Amen? And here, praise is not just an emotional thing. It is a relationship thing. Yeah. Psalms 22 and 3 says this, "But thou art holy, O thou that inhabits the praises of Israel." Another translation says this, that God is enthroned on the praises of his people. Enthroned? Inhabits? Let me tell you, God lives in praise. Yeah. Amen? And when we praise him, we enthrone him and his presence into our midst and into our situation. Saints of God, when we praise him, we enthrone him in our praises, we're inviting him into our trials, we're inviting him into our difficulties, and then I can say, as Paul said, I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me, because there's praise on my lips. And what is happening to me is not defining who I am. What's happening to me now is I'm going to praise my Lord and Savior, who knows how to meet every one of my needs. He knows how to open the prison doors. He knows how to set the captives free. And I'm going to praise him in the midst of all of it. Now, I like to say I do that every time. But I'm practicing it to do it every time. I'm taking authority over my feelings, my emotions, and they're going to line up to the word of God, and I am going to praise him. Amen? Hallelujah. God is good. You see, saints of God, our minds can be filled with praise, or our minds can be filled with the thoughts of the trials. Trials are not meant to fill us. The trials are there. Yes, they will happen. But the trials there, I believe, is just another opportunity for God to prove who he is and another opportunity for me to stand in faith believing that my God is able to deliver and set free. So that simply is this, thanks to God, I believe it's time that we got to get out of our little self-imposed comfort areas and begin to activate praise in our lives. We talked about Holy Spirit activate. Well, it's time to activate praise like we've never activated before. Now, Psalms 150 and verse 1, and we use this a little bit, but I want to hit another point on here. Praise ye the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in the firmament of his power. That firmament means everything underneath his blue sky. We're to praise him out there, everywhere. But praise him in the sanctuary. Where are we at now? The house of God. Amen? But this word praise here is it's in an imperative mood in the Hebrew, which means this is a command, not a suggestion. When God said, praise the Lord, it is a command, not a suggestion. God wants us to praise him, just as like God wants us to pray, that God is a command to pray, a command to witness. There's a command to bring the whole tithe into the house of God. It is a command that God has given to us, and praising is one of those commands. And praising is not done by our feelings. It's done by faith in Jesus Christ. Now, if you're like me, and I'll be honest here, I am an introvert. I know some of you say, how can that guy be an introvert up here? Because the Holy Spirit's hit me up here. But my nature is to hide behind the scenes. I don't like, this is where God's got a sense of humor, I don't like being in the front. I don't like it. It makes me nervous. It makes me sick to my stomach. And after almost 30 years of this, I still get butterflies in my stomach every Sunday morning when I got to get up and preach. Maybe that's a good thing. God's keeping me humble. I don't know. Amen? But I can't use as an excuse, I'm an introvert. Because the command doesn't say, I command you to praise me unless you are an introvert. Doesn't say that. Now, my nationality is German. Germans are stoic. We don't smile. You ever seen the pictures of the old Germans? I got my great-great-grandparents on my wall right now. This is, you know, this Oaks car. And if you're a little kid, they scare you to death. So now I can't use that excuse, well, I'm just a stoic German. That's just who my nationality is. No, it didn't say, you know, praise God unless you're German and stoic. It said, let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. It is a command that God has given to us. And it's not something that's shackling you down. It's maybe something that makes you uncomfortable. But here's what I discovered. If you get outside that uncomfortableness and begin to praise him anyway, you get set free. I love now praising the Lord. I love raising my hands. You know what? And I want to tell you right now, when you begin to obey God's commands, saints of God, your life will be changed even as Christians. Amen? So what is praise? Well, this is the definition. Praise is a physical or a verbal adoration of praise to God. Now, I want to say right now, there are multiple ways to praise God. But one of the best ways to praise God is ask God what his love language is. And how do I know what God's love language is? The scripture tells us. You ready? One of the things that God says as praise is this, your voice. How many got a voice today? It says, shout unto the God with the voice of triumph. Hallelujah. It says, sing unto me a new song. As a matter of fact, part of our praise and our worship is using our voices to praise him. You know, saints of God begin to cry, holy, holy, holy. Now, how many in here got a voice? How many can at least raise it up an octave? Amen. Use your voice to praise him. Amen. You know why we need to use our voice? Because God spoke the worlds into existence. There is power in our tongues. And we begin to speak forth his praise, hallelujah. the one who's called us out of darkness into his marvelous light. And there's another way to praise God. You ready for it? Clapping. Clap your hands, all you people. Shout to God with the voice of triumph. Now, I need help clapping. I cannot keep a beat for nothing. So there's sometimes I'm probably irritating the worship team because I'm on the wrong beat. They're laughing. It must be true. I'm on the wrong beat. So you know what I do? I still try, even if I'm on the wrong beat. But then I look for some of you other ones who are on the right beat. And then I look at you and go, yeah, now I've got it. Amen? Amen? And I'll never forget the time that the church I was at, we sponsored Nigerian families. They were refugees from Nigeria. They'd gone through horrible, horrible, horrible things. It's unimaginable what they went through. They got to the camps, and then we got them here to America. We put them in, we got them places to live, that kind of things. And we turned over one of the service to them. We went a dam to have their Nigerian service in our church service. And I want to tell you, doggies, you talk about excitement. Oh, there was nothing hindering them worshiping and praising their God. They made us look like a bunch of Methodists, okay? They came and the ladies put on these great big turban things. I don't know what they had a name for them. I don't remember them. And they were multicolorful and they were just gorgeous. They were beautiful. And I want to tell you, in their culture, they did not have music. They didn't have instruments. They were so poor. But they did things with their hands and with their mouths. They made noises I could not even begin to imagine and dream about. And they got lost in praise and worship. And I want to tell you, they got out there doing this thing. All of them got out. I can't even do what they were doing, but they were going wild for Jesus. And when it came time to take up the offering, we're like, here, we had a basket we put back there for the offering. And you know what they did? Those ladies got out in the aisle and they started dancing and they were waving their offering and they went back and put their offering in. They came up with music that I never heard in my life, and God honored their worship and honored their praise. And guess what? It wasn't American. It was Nigerian. And it was a glorious thing. And God received it. And you know what I learned from that? God's idea of worship is greater than the American church. Let me finish this point here because I'm running out of time. I'm getting windy again. If we wanted to do first century worship, you ready for this? Jesus never sang Amazing Grace. He never sang There's Power in the Blood. He never sang a song out of an American hymnal ever. Because his culture was Jewish. Their praise and worship would have been Jewish music and songs. Now, have you ever seen Jewish music? Ooh, doggy. I can't get down and do what they do. But their music was totally, totally, totally different than anything that we people in America do. And God received their praise and worship. I don't know if you're aware of it or not, but the Assemblies of God worldwide, not in America, but worldwide, is the largest Pentecostal denomination in the world. In America, we're not, but worldwide we are. And you know what caused that to happen? First of all, we got a mission for missions. That's why God brought us together, was for missions. But when we went into other countries, we did not try to make them American Christians. We used their culture and allowed them to use their music with their songs for their praise and worship stuff. And because of that, they accepted the gospel message, and the churches overseas are growing like crazy. South Africa is growing like crazy. South America is growing like crazy. The church of the Lord Jesus Christ is moving in mighty powerful ways because we were letting them be free enough to worship God in their culture and their way. Now, I'll be honest. If I am going to a hip-hop church, I would have a problem with that. I'd say, pull your pants up. But you know what I would do if I was there? I'd worship right along with them. Because it's not about if I like it or don't like it. It's about worshiping the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. It's about Him. It's not about me. And when praise is about me, I'm praising myself. And God won't share His praise with anyone else. Everyone agree? Now, some physical things here that the Bible tells us that we can dance before the Lord. I'm not saying everyone can dance. If you got bad knees, you don't have to dance. Amen? Some of you are going, shoo. But one of the ways is dancing before the Lord. And I remember the first time God told me to dance before Him, I was in a church. As a matter of fact, my mom had come to the church, and I wasn't about to make a fool of myself in front of my mom. And the Holy Spirit said, dance before me. So I finally did, and I got lost in the Spirit. Who, another way we praise God is raise our hands. Yes. You know, if you got the right answer, you raise your hands, right? Now, how many can at least do this? Yeah. And then you can raise it to here. Yeah. And then you may get to here. And then you may get to here. Hallelujah. Amen? But choose one of these ways. There's other ways that we fall before Him on the floor face first. There's other ways. That's going to be harder for me now. There's other times we get down on our knees and we kneel before Him. There's other ways that we do it, like through these instruments. Psalms 150. These instruments are here to praise the Lord. Amen? Yeah. Hallelujah. Saints of God, when we're praising God, we're looking God in the face, looking God Almighty, and saying, God, we appreciate You, and we declare Your worth to Your face. Amen? Hallelujah. And saints of God, like I said, the sign language, there's all kinds of different ways that we can praise Him. And it's not limited to what we like in our culture. Amen. I'm glad I'm getting drowned out of all the amens. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is so, so good. I'm going to write through here. I'll tell Deonza where I'm going here. Another reason, go to number 7, Deonza. We need to praise because the devil is opposed to us praising God. We know the story about Satan, right? He was created as a beautiful angel, right? And you know what he's in charge of? Imagine that. Why do you think he fights music so much in the churches? Because he created music, he knows the power of music, and he knows what music can do for people's lives. And saints of God, Satan decided, I'm going to raise my throne above God's throne. What a stupid man or stupid angel he was, thinking he could defeat God. And what Satan didn't like, that God was receiving all the praise and all the worship, and Satan wanted to receive praise and worship. So he decided, you know what? I am going to raise my throne to Him, and start a great big war. A third of the angels were cast down to earth. And here's what Satan learned. The devil is allergic to praise because the devil knows the power of praise. Amen. He doesn't want us to praise because the devil knows the power of praise. Yes. Amen? So if the devil don't want us to do it, I need to be like a teenager. Yes. When a teenager tells me I can't do it, you watch and see. Yeah. Amen? Yeah. Next thing is this. Praising God takes our focus off the devil. Instead of being concerned about him and his schemes and his plans, I got my focus off the devil now because I'm praising my Lord and Savior. Amen? You see, when we're praising God, we are reinforcing and reminding the devil of his great defeat and failure. And I enjoy that. Amen? Then last week, next one is this. Praise is a dynamic spiritual force to defeat Satan and his schemes. Praise will do that for our lives. And I'm going to close here real quick here, but you got to listen to me just a little bit longer, and we'll see what's going to happen here in just a moment. But anyway, I started talking about King Jehoshaphat last week. Anyone remember the story? King Jehoshaphat, he had his Bible study, he had his time of prayer together, and all of a sudden all the armies of God, enemies of him, came together as one army against him to come in and defeat him. And all the people came to the king and said, King, what are you going to do here? All the armies are out there. They're going to try to destroy us. They're going to try to kill us. Oh, what are we going to do? And you know what Jehoshaphat said? Let's get a choir together. A choir of praisers. Those who knew how to praise their God. Let's get them together. And you know what Jehoshaphat did? He placed the choir in front of his army. And the choir went into battle before the army. Now, let's be smart here. That's stupid. I want tank. I want artillery. I want warships going in. And I want missiles flying. But he set them out with praise. And you know what the praise of God did? It so confused the enemy. That says that the enemy turned on each other and killed each other, and his army did not have to kill one person. Because the army turned on itself. I want my worship team to come back if you would. The army turned on themselves. And you know what? There's some in this room today, I am convinced right this very moment, that there are things going on in your life and the enemy's coming in against you. And here's what we need to do as a congregation and to an agreement here in this praise and worship here, is that we're going to bring this praise before God and we're going to believe that the enemy is going to turn on themselves and victory will happen. How many can believe that with me? You see, there is a great truth. No enemy that we've ever faced or we will ever face, no enemy of the church that comes against us will be able to stand when we are becoming praisers that God has called us to be. And we are going to praise him with this theme song one more time today. And I want you, right through this song, as we do this song, think of the lyrics, but I also want you to think this way, that through praise, these walls are coming down. These shackles that have held me down are coming loose. My discouragement, my despair, my depression is leaving in Jesus' name. And every weapon that's been formed against me will not prosper in Jesus' name. And I'm going to praise him everywhere in his name. Let's praise him.
Darkness, sing through the fire, praise when it don't make sense. Sometimes you gotta stare down the giant, worship from the lion's den. Sometimes you gotta shout it from the mountain, louder than the valley, trust him when he's gonna get you there. Sometimes you gotta welcome the wonder, wait for the answer. Worship with your hands in the air. I'll praise you anywhere. Praise, give me praise, give me praise in the highest praise. Give me praise, give me praise in the highest. He is worthy. Yes, he is worthy of all of the praise. Sometimes you gotta praise in the prison. Cry out to heaven, shout until the doors swing wide. Sometimes you gotta stand on the shackles, brave in the battle, worship with your hands held high. I'll praise you anywhere. Praise, give me praise, give me praise in the highest praise. Give me praise, give me praise in the highest. He is worthy. Yes, he is worthy of all of the praise. Give me praise, give me praise in the highest praise. Give me praise, give me praise in the highest. He is worthy. Yes, he is worthy of all of the praise. the praise. Faithful all my life, blessings day and night, countless reasons why I'll praise you anywhere. Every promise kept, goodness every step, each and every breath, I'll praise you anywhere. Faithful all my life, blessings day and night, countless reasons why I'll praise you anywhere. Every promise kept, goodness every step, each and every breath, I'll praise you anywhere. Praise, give me praise, give me praise, in the highest praise. Give me praise, give me praise, in the highest. He is worthy, yes, He is worthy of all of the praise. Oh, I will give you praise. Praise you anywhere.
Oh, hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 We give you praise and glory, Lord. Hallelujah. We praise you anywhere, Lord God. Hallelujah. Glory to the Lamb of God. Glory to your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Father, I want to thank you and praise you so much for your word. I want to thank you, Lord, that you've called us out of darkness into your marvelous light. And Lord, I want to thank you also, Lord, that you've called us to praise you, for you alone are worthy. And Lord, I thank you right now in advance for the victories that are coming, for the victories we're going to see, for you are for us, and if you be for us, who can possibly be against us? We give you the praise and glory for all that you're going to do. In your name we pray. And all God's people agreed, said, amen. Real quick, I'm sorry, I went over and I broke my butt. There's the Christmas tree out here, and we've been asked to help buy gifts for kids in need. And there's two children that need gifts. And on the Christmas tree, there's little round ornaments. If you want to help there, take the ornament off, then sign the sheet, either child one or child six, and then go out and buy the ornament. It tells you, or go out and buy the gifts. It tells you what you need, and then bring it back to the church by December 10th. And we want to be a blessing to these kids in need. Everyone agreed, said? Amen. God bless you in Jesus' name. May the windows of heaven be open and poured out, blessings be poured out on each and every one of you. Amen.